Good day to y'all, this is Extreme, and this time I'm going to do a little video about green stuff, the how to use the green, the money, in the top right corner over there, look at me pointing at the money, money, yeah, I know I got a lot, but that's okay. Okay, so, but how to earn the money if you're just a player that isn't really going to get into the program, or someone who doesn't have much money to spend to begin with. Well, there are several options, and I'll go through all options of getting green stuff so that you can upgrade your units and buildings. Yes, and I'm going to advise you on what the best options can be, how to spend the money as well, perhaps. I'm actually doing a little bit of a redo on a video I made 1 year ago. I'm going to remake some videos. Things have changed, you know. Well, for starters, that other video starts with me getting money from logging in. That's been gone for a while. It was a good resource, if you will. Anyway, let's begin. Okay, so the most important way to get money would be... Let's begin with the quests. I'm just going to do a little bit of an order, so I selected in the down right corner, and quests it is. I only got this one open, a new episode. Wait for the next episode, it will be in one of the next versions of the game. It's only 100. Well, that ain't much now, is it? Anyway, normally you get some quests of doing missions, or you get cash for doing upgrades, and the best way to do that is actually upgrading what they advise. That's not a good advice, but you get a 10% discount on any upgrade you do. Yeah, you get roughly 10% back, so maybe I should do a screenshot in there from one of an earlier video, I guess, where I got a lot of tokens. Yeah, sure, I do that. Okay, there we go, looks like that, and I guess do that and you get like, I don't know, 10% to spare. So next would be contracts, there we go. As you can see, these are not complete yet except for this one, and you can see how much the reward is. And complete a contract and you get a little bit of an extra cash. So for example, for today, I got one completed, and if I play a couple of matches, I could complete the other ones, and as you can tell, the amount of money combined would be a lot. I'll put in the total number in the screen right now, because I have been adding up. There we go, and that's the extra money you can earn every day. Not only that, if you complete the contracts, you can open this crate, and this crate offers a lot of money as well. And as you can see, I got a plus 25%. I'll come back to that one after this. Anyway, let's see, guaranteed 100%, 4.8k. That's roughly the same number, I guess, as what is offered for all 5 contracts combined. But well, and then you can get a little bit of an extra randomized, and I get a extra 25% guaranteed, I guess. Let's see, that's a skill card. So I'll go out of this one, I'll go into the skill cards. And I need this screen. And we are going to, let's see, where is the skill card that we need? We got, I guess, no. No, come on, no, no, no. Well, actually there are a couple of skill cards. Couple of skill cards that actually have influence on your green money. So I'll guess I'll just pick them all. Alright, do we have anything special here? War point limit increased, that's good. Yes, let's begin with this one. Can't you select? Okay. Well, I guess the war point limit common increases the daily war point limit. Gun skill level is plus 21%, which means that I can get 21% more war points, meaning I can get like a factor 1.21 faster those war crates, which are filled with goodies as well. So that's one way to increase. And the one that I am talking about would be these at the bottom. Yes, this is also a source of income, just like the contract rate, and this is the work rate, and a lot more money. And as you can see, it grows a little bit exponentially, because that plus 25% is another one. So it's actually 1.5 roughly now that I get more money than others. Yes, because I get these crates faster and I get more money from it. That's how it works. Alright, so let's go back to this list where we left. So the next one would be free case. Decrease free case renewal timer, also 21%, but this is a subtraction, so it's roughly speaking more like 25-26% faster. And the free case would be this one. We are going to this one. There we go. These are the free crates. One on the left, this one. This is a golden one. It's not much, but it still counts. And you can get other items as well. But it's the green we're talking about. And we're solely focusing on the green. Then you got the blue crate, which has just a little bit of money. But it renews much faster and faster. They're actually both free crates if you think about it. You only need to watch a commercial. Alright, so that was the free crates. Do we have anything else? Let's see. War points. Increased amount of war points for different activities. So that means that you get 15% more war points for whatever you do. It's a little bit less than the war point limit. But it makes, instead of doing more battles and stuff to get those war points, just a little bit less battles, you know? So this one actually makes you gaming less, if you're really going for the war points. Then we got the next one, which would be the Skirmish Battle Reward. You get credits gained for Skirmish Battles, plus 50%. That's right, that's a lot. Then we got Tournament Battle Reward. And the same increase of 50%, that's really a lot, plus 50% money. So increase these skill cards as soon as possible if you're one going for the greens. It costs investments though, but it's, at the beginning it's worthwhile. Alright, so let's see. This one's lighting up, I don't know why. Anyway, bugs. Let's see, contract reward increases the amount of cash gained for contracts. Well, it's plus 60%, so that means that the number that I've shown you is actually has to be divided by 1.6. I get a lot more than others at this point. But yes, this one too is very useful if you get green from getting your contracts completed. Okay, this one. So let's continue. Guaranteed credits, that's the one, that's the plus 25% that I am seeing. So increased amount of guaranteed credits and cases. So actually it's the minimal amount, plus 25%, and then it goes randomly to the maximum, I guess. That would be about it. I don't know how it works exactly, but it's like that. So there you have it. Okay, World War Battle Reward. Increase the amount of credits gained for World War Battles. So even there you get credits when you win. Get a little bit of money and plus 30%. It's only of the basic though. If you have other factors, they don't really count. And of course, upgrade cost. This one is not useful because you reduce the cost of upgrades and credits. It's minus 12%, however, the investment is way higher. So if you go for skill card level 20, at tier, I don't know, 4 or 5, rank 4 or 5 is what I should say, then it might be useful in the long run. But if you can manage to get level 20 with the skill cards, then you've spent so much money, it might as well have been on your units. This one is the most useless one out of the bench, but still it counts. So actually reducing costs also counts. Okay, let's see. Yeah, the contracts. So that would be it. That's the 25% that you're seeing. Next one, achievements. You get green and gold for the achievements that you complete. I got 30 gold levels now, and every time when you complete an achievement, you get a little bit of money. It is not much, but it was the first income you could get separately from battle rewards, I guess. They take a long time, don't focus on them all. The one that you could do is all those that are linked to single player. Just complete single player missions over and over again, but focus on the contract. The one that I'm focusing on at the end of every battle would be build 50,000 walls, that would be in PvP battles, and the rest goes automatically. I also do a lot of repairs, but as you can see, that one will be taking a much longer time. If you're playing a game and you see in your match that they have a little bit of damage on your building, it costs 1 or 2 credits in the game. Repair it. It counts. Yes. I'm serious, yeah? So if someone's going to scout your base and you have nothing to hide, let him scout your base. Let him shoot every building. Repair, then let him walk back. It's the fastest way to get this upgrade, to be honest. They scout your base. Anyway, the most other achievements are actually very hard to achieve, except for a few that surprisingly went fast. Now this one for the resistance, destroy 100 buildings with Riflemen and PvP battles. Get that Riflemen maxed up and you're good to go. It only gives 50 gold though. Oh well. Right. As you can see, you can also get gold and gold. And now we are going to the shop. Gold can be converted into credits. I will not be doing this because I got plenty of green, but I'm sorry, XLNL, I'm making a video. And I am going to... well, not sure. If you do this, you can buy 1000 green by spending 10 gold. Yeah. Oh, well, it's... explained down below. Exchange 10 golden credits into 1000 credits. It's not that you are going to buy 10 gold. Let's see, what else do we have? Alright, we are in the shop. Let's go up. Of course, we got these crates that I already showed, but as you can see, you can buy stuff. I am absolutely sure you don't want to buy stuff, but if you have to buy anything, then the ones that I will advice are, let's see, they all cost money. Where are they? There we are. The starter pack, this one is the cheapest. You get 4000 gold, but you can exchange gold for green. Of course, you get tokens. Then the advanced pack is also worthwhile. Second research queue, obviously you get a little bit of green with that one, and gold, and the quick starter pack is also very useful. I find these four to be very useful. Then these upcoming were my own choice, but they only give gold. And it was in the time where we still had skill points instead of skill cards, so that's why I have those. And the last one would be the lucky 30 pack. At a certain point, it was very cheap for me, so I bought that one as well. And that would be about it. That would be the packs. What else do we have to show? Premium! Yes, that's right. If you have premium, you get a little bit more money. 50% extra for PvP victories. And the investment of gold gets cheaper the longer time you got. I advise to get the one day and then skip all the way to the... I don't know which one is cheaper. Well, I can do a little calculation and just put it in the screen afterwards. So there we go. So you get one day for 200 gold and then you get to Save up. Oh, actually, I can tell by looking at it. Okay, don't get the 30 days afterwards. That is not worthwhile. The 180 days. So 1 day and 180 days. So you get 200 gold as investment and a discount of 300 gold. Meaning you save yourself 100 gold. And the 260 days is even better. So don't do the 3, 7 and 30 days. They are not useful. Right, so for clan, of course, the clan does have a green and gold as well, and tokens. Sometimes people buy stuff for the clan, but what's more important is that you go to the clan. Oh, that went to zero, so if I restart the game, I should be getting money, gold and tokens. There we go, let's do that, and then I'll continue explaining. Unfortunately, the money has returned, so it hasn't been distributed just yet. I don't know why. There you go. It is going to be divided this Monday. I don't know why it was zero just moments ago. So never mind that. So every week you get your money from the clan and you get a little percentage. Make sure your activity is very high in the clan to get a lot, but if you have a very high activity, then it's all earned by you. And you simply give it away to others, I guess, I don't know. Right, so the clan supplies, of course, these increase as well. These give money as well, so work together with your clan. Be in the clan, an active clan, and get a lot of crates for the clan, yeah. This moment we again go to 8 and I should work on it as well. Right. So, I've been talking about that one. And of course we need to do battles. So there are a lot of battles right now in the clan going on and they all earn money if they win. Let's see how to inform people about the green stuff you can get for winning a battle. That's a good one. To find it, I guess, yeah, there we go. Right now I'm rank 20, so the costs, entrance costs are subtracted from your account, and then if you win you get a base reward. These are the numbers that I get, so I pay 900 for a world war battle and can get a minimum of 2800. That's not much now, is it? No. What I need to show you is something of a battle that has been won. So I'll have to play a battle first and then show you the money. Crap, that's actually difficult to do because who wants to play right now? No one. Anyway, a couple factors and I'll be showing you that as well. How to get more money. Right then, I guess welcome back to the same episode. Right now I'm actually upgrading stuff in order to get my contracts as done as much as possible. My opponent has left the match already. Lucky me, I guess. I don't know. I fubered him a little bit too fast. I'm going to get mammoths and I'm trying to get hawks ASAP because that's the contract for the day. Perhaps even the construction yard. I don't know if I'm going to play another game. Maybe I'm going to play a lot. So let's see. Yeah, I'm just going to get the construction yard and I'll continue producing. At least the mammoths go well. I'm spending boost on this one. That's something you normally don't do. I just want to get those mammoths done ASAP. That's something I could finish right now. And let's have a little bit of a mercy, I guess. I don't need to kill anything anymore. I don't need the sniper turret, it should be gone. I don't need Desperacks, it should be gone. Ah, the Avia factory is complete. Let's see if I can get a one hog out at least, maybe even a second one. He left very fast. I should do a common production goal. I got plenty of those as well. If you are saving up green, do not spend on boosts like that. Just play a couple more matches would be better. Just going to defragmentate my base. Everything is going well. I got the H quarter 3. I'm just producing as much as possible. So, even though I know that I'm not going to complete contracts, you can only have one special vehicle factory tier 2 at the H quarter 3. Used to be different, so that one is gone. Guess I'll try to get even a third one. Yeah, it's going like this. Meanwhile, work on your other achievements like walls. Because we got plenty of resources spent at getting units anyway. I guess I'll get some walls here as well. It's just a little bit. Every little thing counts. You just need to discipline yourself in doing so. So there we go. We got some hawks. The enemy really had hardly any base. I actually killed his H-squadron with just a couple of riflemen and one coyote. And I got 5 moments. Now 6. Alright, let's have another one. Maybe I should cancel this one first and go for this one first. That would be the last hawk, then I need to kill them. Which is something hard to do. So I'm not going to focus on the hawks anymore. Let's see if I can complete these mammoths. Should I use another let's use a red one then. I think he left at the 4-minute mark. Maybe the 3-minute mark. And let's continue getting. Okay, once this one is done, I'll blow up my airfield. No, wait, then they kill the enemy. And I'll let them stay. Okay, there we go. It goes out. This one's not needed anymore. Boom. Yeah. Ready as always. Alright, so the rest of the money should be spent on walls. Obviously, another achievement would be getting a lot of defense buildings. I'm saving that one for later on. Walls is much more work, to be honest. I got 8 mammoths. I'm not going to complete the contract. There we go. Victory is mine. And the screen we're all waiting for. Oh, by the way, I think this guy, well, he's very good at from Prigovor, but I think he got disconnected at the beginning. So, even though I won this one, it would have been a very tough opponent. But let's continue. What is my victory reward? Well, for starters, to get the most green, you need to play battles. As you can see, the reward is going very high. Let's see. Let's begin with this one. Bonus for activity in battle. I got 100% activity, so I get a 30% bonus. This one is bonus for current win rate. My win rate is only 80. Well, above 70. I lost a very important match yesterday. Why was I smoking weed? Why was I drunk? I even deleted the video because I was starting to say stuff, agreeing with someone. Bad times. Oh well. Let's see, but that's different. Okay, so I am a veteran in the clan. Apparently, for that you get a factor as well. So just stay in the clan as long as possible. Don't leave and rejoin over and over again. You get less green. Then we got this one. Bonus for premium status is 50% extra. And then we got first a victory per day bonus. And this one has been upgraded as well. It's not 13,200 because I thought it was like, I don't know, 5,000? Anyway, it's very complicated. Either way, this is my total. So you can see that you can get a lot of money. And really, I should have. My win rate should be a little bit more. It's strange how your win rate has of influence. You would say that those were stupid enough. I should not. Who have not the skills to win that match should get more money to get those upgrades. Yeah, I should actually explain it like that. That makes much more sense. Balancing the players. I love balancing players. I'm one of the few. Anyway. There we have it. This is how you get money from battles. Any questions? No? Okay, let's continue. And after your battle, you can open a crate. I am going to open this crate. It's an extra crate. Alright, so this time the crate gives me tokens, which is important because that would be the last chapter of this video. Oh, by the way, I can open this one as well. Should open it. See, okay, this is what I get from the crate. Another 10,000 green, and I can get another additional reward. I'll do so. Right, so 10,623 from this site. I don't really need it. I can watch another commercial for an additional 1,351. I am always skipping these because if you watch these, which is important for those who need the green, I am going to miss out on another commercial somewhere else. It's a little bit complicated, but I've noticed that you can watch all commercials except one. I choose this one. As simple as that. Okay, last chapter, tokens. You can get tokens from anywhere in the same way as how you can get green. You can spend tokens only on opening crates. You can get gold from it and green and even boosts. But you cannot get upgrades. So you still need green for the upgrades. And I were going to open a golden one. Just for the fun of it. So if you are going to actually spend tokens on the crates, I got a little bit of advice. I'm now simply doing this. I don't know what I get. It's a gamble. It looks like I'm going to get 7 premium days. There we go. Which means I get the extra money for 7 days more. Anyway, you can look at the question marks above all 6 crates that are displayed in the screen. Sometimes you even got a purple crate, which are even better rewards, but it costs more tokens. If you need the green, you need to spread out your tokens. If you have roughly 100 tokens, I advise you to get the blue crates. You get just a little bit of green. Here's one patch, here's one. I could calculate the average green that you can get from a crate, although the percentage here changes over time, so I can only make an example for now. And maybe next month it's different again. I don't know, we don't know. Here's the third one. Of course, this is only an average amount of gold that you can get. And if I calculate it for you, it looks like this. This is the total amount of green you can get from green and gold from a token of 5 tokens. But that's not all. You can accidentally lose tokens and get tokens in return. These tokens are worth the same if you think about it. It's simply that the 4 over here would actually yield an average amount of green and gold, as you can see in the calculation. And that means that it's actually less. This is just an option that you would be getting a part of it, and then a part of that, and then part of that. That actually grows exponentially, and I'll do the calculations for you, but here's a number for this one. Maybe I should actually take the average amount of tokens and then calculate on that one, so I'll do that. Anyway, all the other options are 0 tokens, so I don't know. Yeah, I should do it individually. Or actually the price. Actually, I could just calculate it for one. I don't know, I'll see. Anyway, let's go back. Let's open another one while explaining stuff. The other crates can be calculated as well. I'm not going to do that. It's a lot of work, as you can see behind the scenes. And I think there will be an end conclusion of which one is better, doing battles or actually opening crates with tokens. Well, it is actually very obvious now. So I guess I'll leave it at this. I hope I have given you new information. I repeated a lot from last time, but some things have changed. I don't know if I forgot anything. Oh wait, I did. I did. Right, single player missions. If you still have not completed them, do so. And if you have plenty of time, just do AI battles for money, if you do not worry about ranking up. I can be very short on those, so there you have it. I hope you all enjoyed watching this video, I hope you learned something from it. If not, just ask me down in the comments, and this is my how to get the green cash in Art of War 3 video. That would be all. So thank you all for watching, and I see you next time. Bye bye now.